जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी,
कुंज बिहारी,
जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, गोपी जान बल्लभ गिरिवर जाहि, गोपी जान बल्लभ गिरिवर जाहि, यशोदा नंदन व्रज जन रंजना, यशोदा नंदन व्रज जन रंजना, यमुन सिरावन चाहे, यमुन सिरावन चाहे, जय राधा माधव कुंज
बिहारी,
जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, गोपी जान बल्लभ गिरिवर जाहि, गोपी जान बल्लभ गिरिवर जाहि, यशोदा नंदन व्रज जन रंजना, यशोदा नंदन व्रज जन रंजना, यमुन सिरावन चाहि, यमुन सिरावन चाहि, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Premanande Hari Om. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskrityam.
Narayanam Namaskrityam.
Naram Chaiva Narottamam.
Naram Chaiva Narottamam.
Devim Sarasatim Vyasam. Tato jayamudirayat nasta prayeshu vabhadreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama shloke bhaktir bhavati naishtaki. We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 4, Chapter Number 25, Description of the Characteristics of King Puranjag. This morning, text number 6. Greheshu kuta dharmeshu. Greheshu kuta dharmeshu.
Greheshu kuta dharmeshu.
Putra dara danartha di.
Putra dara danartha di.
Putra dara danartha di.
Na param vindate mudho.
Na param vindate mudho. Brahmyan samsara vartmasu.
Brahmyan samsara
vartmasu.
Brahmyan samsara vartmasu.
Greheshu kuta dharmeshu. Putra dara danartha di.
Putra dara danartha di.
Na param vindate mudho.
Na param vindate mudho.
Brahmyan samsara vartmasu.
Brahmyan samsara vartmasu.
Greheshu kuta dharmesu.
Greheshu kuta dharmesu.
Putra dara danartha di.
Putra dara danartha di.
Na param vindate mudho.
Na param vindate mudho.
Brahmyan samsara vartmasu.
Brahmyan samsara vartmasu.
Greheshu kuta dharmesu.
Greheshu kuta dharmesu.
Namaste.
Marriages. Griheshu, in family life, Kuta Dharmeshu, in false occupational duties, Putra, sons, Dara, wife, Dana, wealth, Artha, the goal of life, D, one who considers, Na, not, Param, transcendence, Vindate, achieves, Mudha, rascal. Brahmyan, wandering. Samsara, of material existence. Vartmasu, on the path. Translation. Those who are interested only in so-called dutiful life, namely remaining as a householder, entangled by sons and a wife, and searching after wealth, think that such things are life's ultimate goal. Such people simply wander in different types of bodies throughout this material existence without finding out the ultimate goal of life.
译文：那些只想维持被儿子、妻子和追求钱财所束缚的居士生活的状态，只对这种所谓美好的生活感兴趣的人，认为这类事物才是生命中要追求的最高目标。这种人只会在遍布这个物质存在中的各种虚极里流浪，找不到生命的最高目标。
Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Those who are too much attached to family life, which consists of entanglement with wife, children, wealth, and home, are engaged in kuta dharma, pseudo duties. Prahlad Maharaj has likened these pseudo occupational duties to a dark well under kupam. Prahlad has purposefully spoken of this dark well, because if one falls into this well, he will die. He may cry for help, but no one will hear him or come to rescue him. The words Brahmyan Samsara Vartmashu are significant. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya 19.151, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very clearly explains Brahmanda Brahmite Kona Bhagyavanji. The living entities are wandering in different types of bodies throughout different planets. And if in the course of their wandering, they come in contact with a devotee by the direction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, their lives become successful. Even though King Prachini Barishat was engaged in fruitive activity, the great sage Narad appeared before him. The king was very fortunate to be able to associate with Narad, who enlightened him in spiritual knowledge. It is the duty of all saintly persons to follow in the footsteps of Narada Muni and travel all over the world to every country and village just to instruct illusion persons about the goal of life and save them from the entanglement of karma bandha, fruitive activity.
庞拉德王把那些所谓的职责比作是一口黑井，庞拉德王之所以意味深长地谈论这口黑井，是因为料到这口井里的人就会面临死亡，他也许会大声呼救，但没人能听到他的呼救声，也没人会来救他。诗中，在物质存在的道路的各条路上游荡，意味比一句意义重大。 在永恒的《采檀尼亚经》中第19篇的第151节诗中说：“圣采檀尼亚马哈普明确地解释说，众生遍布在不同的星球上的各种躯体中游荡。如果他们在游荡的过程中，借由至尊人格手持的指导接触到一位奉献者，他们的生活就会成功。尽管帕西那巴黑沙普王在忙着从事公益性活动。” 但伟大的圣人拿尔达来到他面前，这位君王很幸运地能够与拿尔达联谊。拿尔达用迷信的知识教育了他，所有圣洁的人都应该以拿尔达为榜样， 走遍全世界的每一个国家和乡村，给迷茫的人们指明生命的目标，把他们从功利性活动的纠缠中拯救出来。
Om Gyanatimarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Nama Vanchakaupata Rubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhai Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Nama Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar, Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. We're hearing about this king, Prachini Barishat, who had the good fortune to be visited by Narada Muni. Narada Muni was traveling everywhere and he came to visit this king.
Narada Muni, 全世界到处在游旅行，他开始来拜访这个国王。
Now this king was, he was a pious king, but he was attached to performing pious activities for material benefit.
这是一位虔诚的国王，但是呢，这个虔诚的国王总是在虔诚的从事各种物质的活动。
And he would do activities like sacrifice animals.
他甚至会做一些动物的祭祀。
And he was hoping that by his sacrifices, he would enjoy in the future. However, he was a good soul and he recognized that he had faults in his life. He is speaking, he is explaining how he's attached to family life. Naturally, you know, you have a wife, you have children, you have a home, you have some money, you're attached to these things. You don't acquire all of these things if you're not attached. If somebody is not attached, then they won't have all of these things. Just like you can see Kardama Muni and Devahuti. Kardama Muni had been living as a brahmachari for 10,000 years.
Kardama Muni, 他是一个 brahmachari 的生活，遵守僧的生活，他苦行了将近一万年。
And then he got his wife. Devahuti came to be his wife. And she was serving him in the ashram. They were living very austerely. Living in the forest. And at a certain point, Devahuti said, you know, I want to have a family. So Kardama Muni understood, he thought, well, okay, if you want to have a family, then we can't just have a, we cannot continue living in this situation. So Kardama Muni used his yoga powers and he created a mansion which could fly in space. And that mansion was very opulent. It was full of all kinds of opulence. There were parks and fountains and beautiful flowers and gardens.
而且他创造的这一个环境呢， 非常的富丽堂皇，有庭院，而且呢，就是非常的奢华。
So Kardama Muni and Devahuti, he also, because they've been doing a lot of austerity, so Devahuti's hair had become all matted, and, you know, her skin was all not so attractive. And so he arranged that when she took bath in the Bindu Sarova, that there were so many ladies there, and they rejuvenated her body. And he made her, they transformed her into a very beautiful woman. And in this way, Kardama Muni could go with his wife Devahuti. They flew to places of material enjoyment. They flew to places people on this planet could never go. They went to places where the demigods go to enjoy, like Mount Meru.
他们就飞到一些地方，那些地方无人问津，但是呢，这些地方非常的美丽。他们甚至有时候会到一些半神人去的地方，比如说，梅乳山。
And in this way, they were enjoying there, and in course of time, they had their children.
他们在那里享受，然后呢，之后他们有他们的孩子。
But Kardama Muni was a renounced person. He'd enjoyed his household life, and then he understood now it's time to give up this family life. So Kardama Muni, he arranged for the marriage of his children.
Kardama Muni 就为他的孩子也做了安排好了各种婚姻。
He had 9 daughters,
还有九个女儿,
and 1 son who was an incarnation of God.
而且有一个儿子是主的化身。
The Shastras say, you're going to have children, you should have a child who's an incarnation of God.
如果你希望有一个儿子的话，经典说，如果你希望有个儿子的话，最好这个儿子是主的化身。
Or at least this, you should think, this child will not take birth again in the material world.
或者说，至少应该让这个孩子再也不要投身到这个物质世界。
This will be the last birth.
这应该是他最后的一生。
And so, like that, Kardama Muni and Devahuti, they had their children, and after they had the children, and the children were arranged for marriage, then he left.
然后呢，就这样，卡达玛穆尼有他的这些孩子，然后他为他的孩子们安排好婚礼之后，安排好这个生活之后，他就离开了。
Of course, Devahuti had her son with her, Kapila, Lord Kapila, to instruct her.
然后 Devahuti 就有他的孩子陪伴着他，他的儿子陪伴着他，就是Kapila。
And after he had instructed her and taught her, then he also left.
当主卡皮拉给了 Devahuti 教导之后，他也离开了。
Because Devahuti was already situated in transcendence.
因为 Devahuti 已经处在超人的层面上。
He'd done his duty for his mother.
他就是主为他的母亲做了这种职责的安排。
So family life can be very good if you're not too much attached to it.
所以家庭生活是也是非常好的，如果你并不依附这种家庭生活的话。
But a lot of people get into family life, they never want to leave it.
但是很多的人他进入到家庭生活之中之后，他再也不想离开这种家庭生活。
But in the Vedic culture, family life is only one part of the life.
但是在伟达的文化之中，家庭生活只是一个人一生旅行之中的一个部分。
The first part is student life.
在最开始是一个学生生活。
Then family life.
然后家庭生活。
And then retired life.
然后退休的生活。
retired life, and for some people after retired life, then comes renunciation.
然后当一些人退休之后，有一部分人他会成为完全弃绝的生活。
Not everybody renounces.
不是所有的人都会进入到弃绝。
But retired life is there. The husband and wife, they can stay together. They don't need to separate.
但是这种退休的生活应该在哪？就是说，丈夫和妻子可以都退休，他们可以不必分开，但是他们都属于退休的状态。
But their material life is over.
但是呢，物质的他们的物质生活已经结束了。
They live together for spiritual advancement.
他们生活在一起只是为了灵性的进步。
Going to visit holy places.
一起去拜访圣地。
Or just maybe just staying at home, but worshiping a deity in the home.
或许只是在家里待着，然后呢，他们俩会一起去崇拜神像。
And regularly inviting guests to come to preach to.
然后有规律的去邀请朋友来给他们传教。
Or having people come to preach to them.
或者去出去传教。
Bringing senior Vaishnavas to come and give classes.
或者说邀请一些进步的奉献者来到家里去给予讲课。
So in this way, the retired life becomes also spiritual, becomes meaningful.
所以这种退休的生活也会非常的有意义。
But material world, common people, they remain in the family life.And they remain attached.
通常情况下，物质生活里面的人，他们都希望保持家庭生活中，然后保持这种依附，对家庭中的依附。
But they remain attached. First of all, the children, and then after the children come the grandchildren.
他们首先是有了孩子之后，然后又有了孙子。
And in this way, they pass the whole life, taking care of the children.And then taking care of the grandchildren, and then by that time your life is already over.
首先要照顾孩子，照顾完孩子之后又忙着照顾孙子，接着这一生就完了。
And you become more attached to the grandchildren than you were attached to the children.
当你有了孙子之后，你就会发现你更依附孙子了。
So it's very important to understand.The dangers in family life.
所以了解到生命，了解到这个情况，其实了解到生活中这样的情况，其实是非常危险。
And Prabhupada quotes Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj was telling his father. He told his father. He said, "You're like an animal in the bottom of a well."
就像圣帕帕德在这里引用了 Prahlad Maharaj 给他父亲讲的话。他说你就像一个动物在一个黑井里面一样。
If an animal falls into the well, very hard to get it out.
如果一个动物掉到一口黑井里面，它是没办法出来的。
And sometimes people fall in the well.
有些时候人们也会掉到黑井里面。
If you go to Vrindavan and take part in the Brajamandal Parikrama,Walking in the forest of Vrindavan for 1 month.
如果你去到 Vrindavan 去参加这个一个月的绕拜的话
then
一个月的森林里面的绕拜
sometimes it happens, people fall in the well.
有些时候这样的情况就会发生，人们就会掉到井里面去。
Because, you know, early in the morning, the devotees are sleeping in the fields, around the fields, and they will go out into the field meet the call of nature, and sometimes they're crossing the field, and there'll be a well there. They didn't know, they fall in the well.
就像去绕拜的时候，早上的时候，天还没有亮，然后呢，人们在田里面，在那个外面住着，在森林里面住着。早上由于想要去上厕所的时候呢，也没有看得很清楚，就掉到井里面去。
And it's very difficult to get them out once they fall in the well.
当人们掉到井里面去之后是很难出来。
So material life is like that.
物质生活就是这样。
It's like falling into a well.
就像掉到一口黑井。
We get attached. How much money have I got?
他总是会依附我到底需要我想要很多的钱。
How many apartments have I got?
我在想我到底需要多少的这个房子呢？
And how am I going to make more money?
我怎么想方设法能够赚更多的钱呢？
I used to spend a lot of time in Hong Kong going to visit wealthy businessmen there.
我以前在香港去的时候经常也会拜访一些那些生意人。
So I remember this one man, he was very old, and he'd already gone through the bypass, heart bypass. You know, his health condition was very poor.
我记得在香港有一位生意人，他年纪已经非常大了，身体状况也非常的差。
He had big factories, he had hotels, he had a lot of money.
他有很多的钱，他有工厂，甚至呢还有宾馆。
But I was with him in his office one day. We were sitting, and he was on the phone, and he was talking to his bank, the bank manager.
有一次我去拜访他的时候，他正在和他的这个银行经理打电话。
And he was saying to the bank manager, "Just tell me what I have to do to make more money."
他跟他的银行经理就是这么说的，我到底需要怎么做才能够赚到更多的钱？
It's so crazy. People get so attached to these things.
这简直太疯狂了！人们总是特别的依附于这些事情。
So we have to recognize the danger of material life.
我们要意识到这种物质生活之中的危险。
And the Vedic culture is arranged to help people to become detached.
伟大的生活，伟大的文化，就是为了帮助人们去不依附。
But common people they're so materialistic, they don't want to hear about these things.
但是通常人们，还有这些物质主义者，他们不愿意去聆听这些事情。
So we are as devotees, we have to show the example to other people.
所以作为我们奉献者，我们应该向别人去展示我们的榜样。
We have to show how to arrange our life so that we can be detached at the end of life.
我们得向别人展示我们是如何安排我们的生活，然后就向别人展示我们是不依附这个物质世界。
Because we know death is coming closer every day.
我们知道这个死亡每一天都在向我们靠近。
We have to be ready to give to leave everything and go on with our life.
我们得做好准备去离开我们现放弃我们现有的这一切，然后达到我们生命之中的目标。
And if we have a lot of attachment at the end of life, we'll come back in the material world.
如果我们在生命的最后还有这么多的依附的话，我们还是得再回到这个物质世界。
They have a hell in Yamaloka for people who are very attached.
在 Yamaloka 就是阎罗王的星球，有一个地狱。
They stitch the body. They stitch it to a bed. They say you're so attached to sleep. They stitch the body so he gets totally attached. He's sewn like cloth is sewn, stitched. You know, they stitch pieces of cloth.They will stitch your whole body. The Yamadutas will stitch your body to some surface.
这个地狱呢，专门是为那些依附的人准备了。那里会有这个狱长，他会把你的身体剪成这种碎片。如果你特别依附的话，他会把你的身体剪成一片一片的这种碎片。
So we encourage devotees, you know, we have to cultivate attachment to Krishna.
所以我们鼓励奉献者应该发展出对 Krishna 的依附。
And Srila Prabhupada said, you don't give your money to Krishna, then you'll give it to the lawyers or the doctors.
圣帕帕德说，如果你不把钱给予 Krishna 的话，你就会把钱给予医生和律师。
the lawyers, because people will be fighting for the money, they'll be arguing.
因为这些人们就会合理争论，就会合理争争抢这些钱。
After somebody dies and they leave money, then all the family fight over the money. I should get this, I should get that. They're all quarreling with each other.
因为有人，比如说有人死了之后，所有的家庭成员都会开始争吵、争抢着。哦，这是我的钱，那是我的钱。
Or else, old age, you get sick. They put you in the old people's home. They spend a lot of money staying in the old people's home.
然后当你年老了之后，你就开始疾病缠身，人们就会把你放到这种老年之家，在那里面待着。
老人院呢？
老年院。
嗯 ，Yeah， and you have to be the and you know, and what the one devotee was telling me, he had to go in the hospital for a few days, and he saw in the hospital, he said there were some old people there, and they had a maid there taking care of them.
嗯，有最近有人告诉我，他说他得去医院几天，他在医院里就观察到那些老年人，很多老年人就住在医院，然后呢有一个护士就会照顾着他。
有每一个人有自己的保姆。
每一个人有自己的保姆去照顾他。
And they were the lady, the maid, she's just watching the television all day.
但是呢，那个保姆可能就是每天就只是看电视。
And the old person's laying on the bed helpless, you know.
然后那个老年人呢，就躺在床上，完全是处于一种无助的状态。
He wants something he can't get, can't understand, can't see anything.
他在床上躺着，然后他需要什么，但是他什么也看不见，他也得不到他想要的东西。
But the maid is just her whole day there is just to watch television.
这些保姆呢，就只是整天看电视。
And the doctors come and they'll say, oh, they'll give this medicine, that medicine, or they'll put you in ICU. If you're in intensive care thing, ICU, then very, very expensive, big money.
然后当你出现重大问题的时候，那些医生就把你放到这个重症监护室里面。但是呢，你去重症监护室里面待一天两天，那得花很多很多的钱。
And most people go in that ICU.80% of them die.
但是呢，百分之八十进到重症监护室里面的人 ，ICU 里面的人，他们都死了。
Very few people go continue their lives.
只有极少数的人能够继续他的生命。
So this is your money. The money spent in these things.
这就是你的钱会花到的地方。
So better use it for Krishna. You get some benefit.
所以最好把你的钱用在 Krishna 上，你至少还能得到一些益处。
Unless you did something for the service of Krishna, it's eternal benefit.
你为 Krishna 做一些服务，将会得到永恒的益处。
So Prachini Barishat, this king is asking Narada Muni, please help me get out of this entanglement.
所以这个国王把心里那个傻就问哪儿的，请。就跟 Narada 询问，请你帮助我，请你帮助我从这种状况中解脱出来。
So you can read more.
你可以从这个网站之中去读到更多。
Okay. Any question?
好，我们有问题吗
？Maybe one question.
我们回答一个问题。
Nobody has any questions. Everybody agrees, right?
没有人问问题，意味着你们大家都同意，是吗
？Yes, Maharaji.
如果我们把钱都花在 Krishna 身上，我们奉献的老的时候，如果奉献的话，那没有钱看医生怎么办呢？
No, she's saying, when we get old, if we give all our money to Krishna, when we get old, we have no money. What are we gonna do? Well, what you can do, you can go.To the holy dham, go and stay with the devotees, take shelter of the devotees. If you've given all your money to Krishna, then the devotees will also give you shelter.
如果你把钱都给予 Krishna, 给予奉献者，给予 Krishna 的话，你可以在年老的时候，你去到圣地，然后呢，由于你把钱给予了 Krishna, 你托付于 Krishna, 然后呢，到你年老的时候，奉献者也会照顾你。
You have to have faith.That Krishna will take care of you.
你需要有一点信心 ，Krishna 会照顾你。
Krishna will send an airplane from Vaikuntha to take you back to Vaikuntha.
Krishna 会从外昆塔派一架飞机，你直接把你从外昆塔，直接把你从这儿接走。
You don't have to worry. You have to have faith that Krishna will take care of you.
你不用担心 ，Krishna 会照顾你。
If you surrender,
如果你真的是臣服的话
，you have to surrender your life to Krishna.
你得把你的生命臣服于 Krishna.
Then Krishna will take care of you.
这样 Krishna 能够照顾你。
我还有个问题，就是圣帕帕德也说过，他说奉献的生命。
She's saying that if we're sick, usually take a medicine, but the Bhagavatam is the medicine. Devotees, we don't need medicine, we just need to take the Bhagavatam, hear the Bhagavatam. Yes, very good.The Bhagavatam is the real medicine for material life. So if you hear the Srimad Bhagavatam regularly, that's the best medicine. Protect us from material life. Okay, thank you very much. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Go back to Vrinda Ki.
Affection is a common thing to all human beings. In a family, all family members are Krishna devotees, so we get attached with them. Is it wrong?
如果我们对这个，如果我们家庭成员都是奉献者，但是我们又很依附这些家庭成员的话，就是又是奉献者又是家庭成员，这样的依附到底是对的还是错的？
Well, you have to see how that, what is that attachment? Is it just sentimental attachment? Just because they're your family members? We're supposed to think all the devotees are our family members.
所以你得思考一下这个依附到底是什么？你是那种感情用事的依附呢？还是说别的依附？你应该是所有的奉献者都为你的家庭成员。
We have a big family.
我们有一个大的家庭。
We don't just think only our seminal children, our family.
我们不仅仅应该认为是我们自己生的孩子就是我们的家庭成员。
We have to see the spiritual platform.
我们应该在那一种灵性的这种层面上去看。
We're all brothers and sisters.
我们都是兄弟姐妹。
Krishna is the father.
Krishna 是我们的父亲。
But you get attached to your own little family.
你只是依附于你的这个小家庭。
It's based on bodily conception of life.
而且这只是一种躯体的这种概念。
It's not spiritual.
它不是灵性的。
You give all your money to your children.
你把你的钱都给予你的孩子。
That's not spiritual.
这不是灵性。
And your children never come to temple.
而且你的孩子从来都不来庙会里面。
Hardly.
很少。
But we think, oh, it's my duty.
这个是我的职责，你就这么认为。
So, you know, if you think everything for your child, for your children, for your family, that's just material consciousness, bodily consciousness.
如果你的脑子里面总是想着你的家庭，你的孩子。这是一种躯体的概念，
You're in the well.
你是在井里面。
We're trying to get you out of the well.
我们想把你从井里面拽出来。
We're throwing the rope and we're saying, hold the rope.
我们给了你一条绳子，然后告诉你抓紧这个绳子。
But you're in the bottom of the well. You're saying, oh, get me out, get me out.
但是你呢，在井里面，你还是处于一种躯体化的概念。你还是会说，哦，请把我带出去，请把我带出去。
Mercy, hold the rope, we'll pull you out.
我们一直在说，把绳子拉着，然后我们就把你带出来。
And we say, oh, I don't want to hold the rope, just get me out.
但是你还是会说，我不想抓这个绳子，我就是想出去。
So, You have to understand. You have to hold the rope. I mean, the rope is the instructions of Sadhu, Shastra, and Guru. And by their help, we can get out of the well. Okay, Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki. Srimad Bhagavatam ki. Gaur Premanande.